Have you ever wanted to download just one or two pages of a Google book, but found that you have to download the entire file instead of just the pages you want? Or worse, you need a page from a book that's in preview mode, and preview mode books cannot be downloaded at all. Well, I'm going to show you how you can grab a single page from a Google book right after this. Hey there, genies. I'm Elizabeth, and welcome back to Heart of the Family, where we help you make the past part of your present. If you aren't a subscriber of this channel, I would really appreciate it if you would hit the subscribe button and ring the little bell so you'll be notified when new videos are posted. Okay, so you found a book on Google that's about a zillion pages long, and you only need one single page. But you can't get it unless you download the whole book. Or worse, you found a page displaying that you need in a book that's in preview mode, and you can't get it because you can't download those at all. Well, let me show you my trick for grabbing a single page from Google Books. Okay, so let's jump right into Google Books with our Chrome browser. Now, make sure that you are in classic Google Books. But if you find yourself in this view, which is the new Google Books, then just click on the X right here to get out of classic of new Google Books, and then click back to classic Google Books. And that will bring up this view. So as you can see here, I've opened up a book called Dropped Stitches in Tennessee History, which is available for a free public domain book on Google. So I'm going to search for my ancestor, Leroy Taylor, who I know is in this book. And here he is on page 59. So let's open that up and we see Leroy Taylor. And full disclosure, I've already read this book and I have it in my files, and I really love this story about my ancestor because he was a prominent citizen and a legislator from Tennessee, but this is the story of how he got in trouble for swearing in a 1788 meeting, and he had to pay a fine and put some money in the swear jar. So I love that it kind of shows that having a potty mouth is kind of a family tradition, but that's a story for another video. So moving on. All right, so once you have found the page that you want to save, you're going to right click somewhere on in the window and select Inspect down at the bottom, right here. So this is going to bring up what might look like a scary looking window with a bunch of code in it, but don't worry, you're not going to break the internet or your computer, and you don't know how to read code at all in order to download a page. In fact, we're not even going to do anything with the code at all, so just ignore it. So instead, you're going to go up to the top and click on the tab that says Sources. And when you open the Sources tab, you're going to see a list of folders here and a file with little arrows and drop-down options. So we want to look for the one up at the top here where there's a picture of a cloud and it says Books. So click the drop-down arrow to reveal the contents. And now what you see is a few folders that we can ignore right here, and then a series of little green page icons. And each of these is an image of the pages that you've already viewed, including their search previews. So if you look carefully, you can see that there's a whole bunch of gobbledygook here in the file name. But if you know what you're looking for, you can also see the page number. So look where it says PA, followed by a number. That is the page number. So I'm looking for page 59 of the book. And if I click on PA 59, first we see the little snippet, And then underneath, we see the actual image of the page that I was viewing. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to hover over this page here. I'm going to left click on it, hold it down, and then I'm going to drag it up to the top to make a new tab and let it go. And what that just did is that it opened that image up in its own new tab, and the image file is here by itself. And now you have freed that page from the Google Book, and you can download the image to your computer by doing a right click, save as, and then just save it to your computer where you can find it again. Alternatively, you could right click on the page and select copy link address, open up a new tab, paste it in, hit enter, and there is your page, and then go ahead and save it. But I really like the drag and drop method because it's faster. Now it's important to note that this trick only works with Google Book pages that you have recently viewed on your computer. So you can't just type in a page number and expect the image to show up. So the first thing that you want to do is view all of the pages that you want to download so they will be cached or stored by your browser and show up in this list here when you go into it, inspect. Don't forget that you also want to make a copy of the title page of the book for your files, and so you have that information for your source citation. And to do this, you may need to scroll all the way back to the title page in the book if you haven't already viewed it. So let's go back and look at that. Here we have the title page and all that information. And let's go back to inspect. Sources, books, and now we have a whole bunch of pages because I passed all those by as I was scrolling back. So we need to kind of look for it. And generally the front of the book is prefaced by PP. It may vary by book, but you want to be looking for not a PA, but a PP. And so be careful on this one because there may be a cover image that's very tiny, and that is the book's thumbnail. And you don't want that because that's going to be too tiny to print. So keep looking until you find the image. So here we go. Here's the one that we want. I'm just going to take it, hold it, drag it, drop it, and here we go. And now I can make a right click, save, copy for my computer. If you want to go back to reading the book, just get out of inspect mode by clicking the little X, and then all of that goes away. And that is how you download a single page from a Google Book. Now, it's important to mention that this trick only seems to work in the Chrome and Edge browsers. I have not been able to make it work in Firefox or any other browser. And don't forget that you also need to be in classic Google Books view. So that's all for today's video. Please like and subscribe. I'd really appreciate it. Thank you for watching, and as always, keep making the past part of your present.